Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be doing a clean and decor with me, and today we are focusing on our playroom that also doubles as a guest room. Now if you've been with me for a while, you know that I have really not done like anything to our guest room or playroom, and we have been here almost a year. If you guys can relate to that, let me know, because I just cannot believe that it's been so long and I've neglected it for so long. So I am obviously very, very excited to be going ahead and getting this done today. And I'm also really excited to be partnering with JCPenney on this video. I love JCPenney. I think they have amazing quality products, and I also love taking advantage of their sales, because I think with their sales, you can get a lot of really high quality products for really inexpensive. You guys know that I really love a good sale and getting things on a deal. So I'm really excited to be working with them for this video. So before we get into it, I do wanna let you guys know that there will be a giveaway on this video. So definitely stay tuned for that. You guys are not going to want to miss this. And I also will have all the information for that down in the description box below. But let's go ahead and jump on into this. We will get this place cleaned up and looking good. So the first thing that I needed to do in the morning was to go ahead and just wash our sheets. And my first thought on these sheets whenever I pulled them out of the package is, oh my gosh, they were so, so soft. It definitely makes me jealous that I'm putting these upstairs. I'm definitely going to be getting a set for our bedroom, because these are amazing. They are so, so soft. So I am just using our homemade detergent. I will link that up here for you guys if you have not seen that. But I just went ahead and washed and dried them, so they were all ready to go when I started decorating the room later that day. Moving upstairs to the playroom slash guest room, I needed to go ahead and tidy up the kids' toys. Normally I do have the boys come help me, but they were actually playing quietly by themselves, so I was not really going to mess that up, especially because I had a lot to do. So on this day, it was just a lot easier for me to go ahead and pick up a few of the toys, and it wasn't really that terrible in here right now as far as toys go, so I just figured I would go ahead and take care of those myself. We recently did a huge toy purge. I will leave that up here in an iCard and also down in the description box, but this was such a needed thing in our playroom, so we got rid of a ton of toys, and because of that, I was actually able to move our little kitchen into our closet because we had more room in there now, and doing that just really opened up the playroom and gave me a lot more options in here. But it's still really accessible for the kids, so whenever they want to pull it out and play with it, it'll be super easy to just pull it out of the closet. Next, I just needed to strip the bed of our old sheets. These sheets were really inexpensive. Like, I don't know, I might have paid $10 for them. They were definitely not the highest quality sheets. Sometimes I kind of cheap out on things like that, but I'm super excited to be replacing those sheets with some really high quality ones this time. And then after I did that, I just started vacuuming our floor. And as I've said before, this is our Dyson V8. I really love this vacuum. It just makes everything so convenient, and I love all the attachments that it comes with. Moving on to our little cube organizers, these just really needed a good dusting, and I realized they actually needed not just a dry dusting, but definitely like a wet dusting. So I'm just using my dry duster, and then I'm also using my all-purpose e-cloth to just wipe everything down, and then finishing off the TV with my glass and polishing cloth. So once the room was all nice and clean, it was time to go ahead and pull out our bed. This is just a day bed, but it pulls out into a king size bed, so we just needed to add on the other mattress and then start fixing it up. So the first thing that I got from JCPenney is this Sensorpedic 3-inch cooling memory foam topper. I was so, so excited to get this. If you have cheap mattresses like we do,
These mattresses were under $100, I think, and they do the job, but when we have someone staying with us for a week or longer, it kind of gets a little bit uncomfortable for them. Using a mattress topper is a really great way to elevate your mattress feel, and it's a lot more affordable than buying brand new mattresses, especially if you need to buy ones that feel actually really comfortable. I definitely recommend getting a mattress topper. And this particular one has a cooling technology, so it actually will keep you cool. I laid on it for a while when it was fluffing up, and it was so, so comfortable. I'm pretty jealous of it. I'm probably going to be getting one for our own bed downstairs. So once I gave our mattress topper about 20 minutes or so to kind of fluff up, I needed to go ahead and just put our sheet set on. And these are the sheets that I was talking about earlier. These specific ones are the Liz Claiborne Supima Cotton 750 thread count sateen sheets. They are so incredibly soft. I cannot even tell you how soft they are, but they are definitely the softest sheets I have ever felt. And they are also cotton, which is something that I found over the last few years I really, really love, because cotton sheets are really, really soft, but at the same time, they are nice and crisp. So that is like my favorite kind of sheet, is a 100% cotton sheet, which these ones are. I am definitely going to be getting a set for my bedroom downstairs because they are amazing and 100% better than the ones that we have on our bed right now. Another thing that I really, really loved about these sheets is that they have really deep pockets for thick mattresses, and also if you're putting on a mattress topper like I did here. And they also fit really snug against the corners without slipping, and they say that they are fade resistant, so I'm super excited to see how they hold up because I'm planning to have these ones for quite a while. Once the sheets were on, I needed to put on our new comforter, and this comforter is the Liz Claiborne Level 2 Down Comforter. I wanted something kind of middle of the road as far as heating goes, so JCPenney has a Level 1, Level 2, and Level 3 comforter, Level 3 being the warmest, and I decided to go ahead and choose the Level 2 comforter just because it's kind of in the middle, and I didn't think we needed something crazy warm. I also love that it has baffle box stitching, and that way it's not going to be clumping or anything, especially whenever you wash it, which also this one is machine washable, and that is definitely a must for me because I just do not have time to take all of our comforters down to get them dry cleaned. So I love that this looks so pretty and feels so nice, but it's also really easy to take care of.
Okay, so I'm kind of done. I mean, not like totally done. I still need to do things to the walls and like a few little decor pieces, but the bed is done. And having it all pulled out, I'm just not really sure what I think of it.
So this is the view when you walk in the room. Like, I'm just standing at the door right here. And when it's pulled out, I feel like, I don't know, I'm not sure if I love it or not. Plus, it's super hard to make the bed when it's like pushed up against the wall. The nice thing is that like everything's right there, and so you're able to see the TV that way. I don't know. Let me know if you guys think I should keep it this way or if I should try and rearrange it again. Well, I decided to go ahead and change this around already. I really just did not like how it looked with the furniture being where it was at. Let me know if you guys are like this too, and once you get something totally decorated, you just don't like it and you have to pull everything apart and start over from square one. I feel like I do this all the time and I'm just so picky, but once I get it right, I can definitely feel like, yes, this is the way it is. And you guys will see, but as soon as we got this room finished, Kyle walked in and he was like, oh my gosh, this is exactly how it was supposed to be from day one. I can't believe we never figured this out before, but this looked amazing, and this is definitely how we were supposed to do this from the start. So I'm so excited to show you how we ended up finishing this room out. I never thought that I would see you tonight. We lock eyes and you smile. Every single memory comes back to life. Your lips press against mine after a night out. Okay, so excuse all the mess, but, and this is the mess I'm talking about, all the bedding, but I think I might like this better. So we just have that little shelf over here, and then we have the bed here, and then it can pull out in that way. Like, if you're staying here, you can actually not have to climb in over by the corner. You can just climb in regular, and then I might end up putting like a plant or like a lamp on either side or something. I don't know. I think I like this idea better. So I was really stubborn as I was moving the bed, and I wanted to move everything so I didn't have to remake the bed, but it just didn't work out, and I ended up having to take everything off the bed and start over. So that's what I'm doing here, is just kind of remaking the bed again. But let me tell you, having it not stuffed in the corner made it so much easier to make this bed, and I'm sure that it's going to be way nicer for guests to go ahead and sleep on a bed this way instead of being stuffed into the corner. And definitely check out the link below because JCPenney is having an amazing white sale right now. And all of these items, plus a ton more bed and bath items, are going to be on a crazy sale. So you guys definitely have to go check that out and get some of these items for yourself to go ahead and elevate your space on a budget. And really quickly, I'll just tell you guys about the giveaway that I have going on. So in this giveaway, you'll be entering to win some similar home products to what I'm showing you guys here. I'm so excited to be able to offer this giveaway to you guys. I have been wanting to share something like this for a while with you, and I'm really excited for the opportunity to do that. So as I said before, I will leave all the information and rules to the giveaway down in the description box. So to enter this giveaway, all you have to do is go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you are not already. Just leave me a comment letting me know which of these products was your favorite. And this giveaway will end in 1 week, so definitely make sure you enter to win. I am just so grateful for the opportunity that I have to go ahead and give back to you guys. The last touches that I needed to do for our bed was just to put our pillows on it. Let me know if you guys go a little bit crazy with pillows and put a lot of extra throw pillows on yours, or if you just keep things really nice and simple and just do the regular pillows that you actually sleep with. I used to just use regular pillows, but probably about 4 or 5 years ago, I started adding some throw pillows on top and front, and I just love the look. I think it makes it look so nice, and it's like you don't even have to try, you just toss the pillows on there, and it just really elevates the look and makes it look so much more inviting. So once the bed was made for the second time in the place that I actually wanted it to be, I went ahead and started putting up some of our decor. So Kyle had just gotten home from work and I had to have him help me hang this up. One of my biggest tips for hanging pictures is to just use command strips. Now these ones are the Velcro command strips and I really like that because you can kind of reattach it to the wall if you end up getting it in the wrong spot. But they are so convenient to use and they don't damage your walls or anything, so whether you kind of move things around on your walls quite a bit or if you are renting and you don't want to put holes in your walls, these are definitely the way to go. Do you miss me at all? Do you think about the things we used to do? No, you couldn't stand tall. So why didn't you call? And then once we got that hung up, I wanted to have something in this corner. So this is just a tin container that I already had. And then I just have some wooden sticks in there and I wanted to have that on that side. And I thought that would just give a lot of height to that area. And I thought it would just kind of fill up the awkward space next to the bed. But why didn't you call? Then on the other side of the bed, I just added this tall lamp that has some shelves in it, and I added a globe to kind of work with that travel theme. And then I also got some little books, and I just took the covers off because I felt it looked a little bit nicer and cleaner that way. And I just absolutely love how this room turned out. I think it turned out so good. I do have a plan to put up some curtains behind the bed, but we'll have to get to that another day because that was kind of a last minute idea I had. Do not forget to go check out JCPenney because as I said, they are having that huge white sale. You guys will not want to miss out on that. And also be sure to enter into that giveaway. I hope you guys have an amazing day. Do not forget to subscribe down below if you are not already, and then head over to Instagram and follow me over there as well. And I will see you guys in my next one. Why didn't you call? So many years has gone by, but I think about you all the time. Looks like you're changing and all.